ordinary fun of the age he lived in?
No, and that comes through very much in his book, which is The Ordeal of Gilbert Pinfield, which people have always drawn attention to as if it was a portrait of him, which it was. I mean, the Pinfield of this monstrous figure who was the hero or anti-hero of The Ordeal of Gilbert Pinfield is undoubtedly him, but it's also very much a caricature that he's playing up to the caricature of himself, which he was quite happy to accept as a means of keeping other people at bay. There's a very famous passage in Pinfield, which is often quoted. I might even read it. I could read it to you.
Right?
Yeah. This is writing, even more writing about this imaginary man, Gilbert Pinfield. His strongest tastes were negative. He abhorred plastics, Picasso, sunbathing and jazz, everything in fact that had happened in his own lifetime. The tiny kindling of charity which came to him through his religion sufficed only to temper his disgust and change it to boredom. There was a phrase in the 30s, "It is later than you think," which was designed to cause uneasiness. It was never later than Mr. Pinfield thought. And he, I don't know to what extent it was an affectation, but he was always talking about how much he was looking forward to death, which is slightly depressing, the father of a family, when you go back for the holidays and you have this father saying how much he was hoping to die quite soon.
Ce fut le silence. Le couloir était désert. Mr. Pinfold monta sur le pont et ne vit personne. Avec stupeur, il constata qu'il n'y avait aucun autre bateau en vue, aucune lumière jusqu'à l'horizon, aucun bruit sur la passerelle. Rien que le clapotis des vagues contre la coque du Caliban et la douce brise marine. Il n'en fallut pas davantage pour briser sa résolution. Il se sentit envahi par une terreur intense, totalement différente de la crainte superficielle qu'il avait éprouvée une fois ou deux déjà dans des moments de danger. Une terreur dont il avait souvent lu la description sans vouloir y croire. Une sorte de panique atavique qui le dominait tout entier. « Mon Dieu, gémit-il, ne me laissez pas devenir fou. »